Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. For a long time now I have been a fan of Sabo in California. He's an irreverent artist who is libertarian in nature and extremely talented. He did the coolest poster of Ted Cruz as a vampire hunter, and that's just one example of his work. He's done other pieces dedicated to President Trump which are just as cool. But his best work is anti-liberal, and a number of those features politicians such as Maxine Waters, Nancy Pelosi, and Hillary Clinton. Hollywood and Los Angeles have never been the same since Sabo and unsavory agents arrived on the scene to level the political playing field somewhat. Did I mention he's gloriously brutal? It would seem that Sabo is not alone in his artistic political statements either. A group called The Faction has surfaced in Hollywood, and it's driving leftist celebrities out of their minds. You'll remember how President Trump's Hollywood Walk of Fame star has been destroyed multiple times. And when conservatives have held vigils by the star to show support, they have been physically attacked by leftists, resulting in numerous arrests and a number of injuries. The Faction is loosely connected to Sabo, and they decided that every time Trump's star was damaged, destroyed, or dissed in some gross physical manner, at least 30 more Trump stars would pop up on that famous foot traffic thoroughfare. Good to their word, and under the cover of night, these young artists dressed up in neon orange construction vests and hard hat helmets and went about making their statement with huge signs that will really make anti-Trumpers raging mad in Hollywood. The final straw was probably when the city council there voted unanimously to remove Trump's star. The leftist mayor says it will stay, but who knows? And might I just add that if Trump's star is removed because of how he's allegedly offended women, they should have to remove most of the stars there for male actors. The Hollywood Reporter put it this way: the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce and Los Angeles City Council haven't weighed in on the matter, but those who oppose the proposal note that others in Hollywood who have also been accused of mistreating women still have stars on the Walk of Fame, most notably Bill Cosby. Our heroes laid down heavy, vinyl stars that look exactly like the real thing. Dozens of them were found the next morning. The stars even surrounded others such as late-night host Jimmy Kimmel and actor, director Rob Reiner. They must have blown a gasket. I hope they put them around Robert De Niro's as well. We'll probably never hear the end of that. Lol. And even though it was a magnificent piece of political theatrics, the artist wants to stay anonymous for obvious reasons. Conservatives and those who lean right are not exactly popular in Hollywood these days, to put it mildly. This artist is on a mission for Trump and his star, and he's not done yet either. Rip up the President's Walk of Fame star, or try to have it removed, like you're the mayor of West Hollywood or something, and 30 more will pop up, the artist told the Hollywood Reporter. They spent $1,000 on the vinyl stars. They printed them on sheets of floor vinyl with adhesive backing, and their mission was partially financed by a young and anonymous entrepreneur. Ah, conservative capitalism at its finest. That's a guy I'd love to meet and call a friend. Trump haters, of course, were not amused. To the Trump supporter who proudly restored Trump's star on Hollywood Boulevard. You do realize that people piss on that thing all night, every night, right? I mean, does he really want to be? Oh, Dana Gould, at Dana Gould, August 11, 2018. Some dude spent $1,000 on fake stickers of Donald Trump's star. BC people keep destroying his real star. So if you're by Hollywood Boulevard, do me a favor and help me waste that guy's money by destroying the fake stars. pic.twitter.com/oddutronf, Alana Baldwin at Alana_Baldwin_, August 12, 2018. The Faction laminated the vinyl stars and placed them on blank squares on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. But they kept them covered until all were secured into place so that onlookers would not know exactly what was happening and couldn't stop them. I didn't want to get hit over the head from behind. We thought Trump derangement syndrome was a joke, but I'm pretty sure it's real, the artist said. If no one peels these off, they could last there for 10 years. Donald Trump's star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, that has been destroyed on several occasions, mysteriously multiplied overnight so that on August 9th there were 30 stars. https://t.co/gpvincomp3, Hollywood Reporter, at THR, August 9th, 2018. Well, they won't be there that long, unfortunately. They have already been mostly removed as I understand it. Ripley's Believe It or Not employee said the stars began to be peeled off because we didn't want to have what happened to the old star here. Not only would the star be destroyed, but it would damage our property. Too bad they didn't stay down longer. The screaming from leftist celebrities would have been impressive and memorable. A member of the cleaning service that deals with daily graffiti and vandalism on the Hollywood Walk of Fame said, "We started at 5 o'clock in the morning and we've found about 50 stars," a street vendor added. "I was surprised. It looked pretty real. I can't wait to see what happens here if Trump's star is vandalized again on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Look for his star to multiply everywhere on the walkway if that happens. Then you can watch the sheer panic of celebrities fully in bloom. I hope these guys take this on the road all over California. Heck, the East Coast and across the nation as well. I'd happily pitch in. This is my kind of social justice."